All right, this is it, guys. The 6th anniversary on JP officially begins, and normally I would have something else to say, but I'm honestly just so excited to get into the news. So without further ado, let's jump right in. Oh, by the way, you might have noticed that these arts for the Mastered Ultra Instinct Goku and the Super Saiyan Blue Evolution Vegeta are brand new, right? So there's a very good chance that these are the TUR arts for the Goku and Vegeta, respectively. Okay, so moving on from there, we have the special movie for part one of the anniversary. It was really, really dope with the preview for Goku and Vegeta's animations. And yeah, I'm sure you guys saw it when you first started the game. It was awesome. And we also have, of course, a login bonus, and it's gonna be 3 stones per day along with some other good stuff. I was kind of hoping for more stones, but they did say in the, you know, Dokkan Now video from yesterday that it was gonna be 3 stones, so not really a surprise. And of course, some special missions and also daily missions right here. And this Rebrand thing, I believe, is one of those like community campaigns where we all have to work together to accomplish certain milestones, and then everybody gets those rewards. Okay, of course, we'll check out the details for all this stuff on their own pages in a second. After that, we have the main event of the anniversary, the Dual Dokkan Fest between LR Super Saiyan Blue Evolution Vegeta and Mastered Ultra Instinct Goku. Now, these must be the SSR arts. So we have the SSR arts, we have the TUR arts, and obviously yesterday we saw the LR arts. And for once, I would have to say that, I mean, the TUR and the SSRs look really clean. They really do, right? But I would have to say, I think the LRs actually look the best. Or maybe the SSRs this time, actually. Like, I'm not the biggest fan of the TURs, if these are in fact what they are. I mean, they look fine, but it's between the LRs or the SSRs for me. Let me know in the comments down below which ones you guys like the best. But obviously, they all look amazing, so it doesn't really matter. So that's the Dual Dokkan Fest, and of course, they don't tell us the date or the time, but we pretty much know when it's gonna happen. It's gonna be right after the live stream tomorrow, starting at 11 p.m. Eastern Standard Time or 8 p.m. Pacific Standard Time. Quick reminder, I will be doing a live reaction slash viewing party with my boys, Toon Rami and Jinro, so make sure to check us out over there. And once again, it's gonna be 11 p.m. Eastern Standard Time, and pretty much as soon as the stream ends, or maybe like an hour or two after, the banners will be dropping. I am gonna be doing a separate stream for my summons, and also some collabs on the way, so definitely look forward to that as well. So yeah, Dual Dokkan Fest, and of course these are the preview images for the Goku and Vegeta's Dokkan events, and yeah, that looks really sick as well. I mean, everything about these guys is just really, really well done. So this is the 66 unit multi guaranteed LR banner, and there's going to be 2 versions. One's going to be with ticket, one's going to be with stones. And the banner's not live yet, so I don't know exactly how many stones it's gonna cost, but I'm assuming it's gonna be between 200 to 250. Since last year's was 55 units for 200 stones, maybe this year they're gonna bump it up to 250 for 66 units, or maybe they'll be nice and just make it 200 stones still, but you know, still with one guaranteed LR. And in terms of the ticket banner, I know there's gonna be a lot of questions. We will not be able to actually do the multi until most likely part 3 of the celebration, just like last year, because they want us to collect the tickets throughout parts 1, 2, and 3, right? So don't worry about not being able to do the multi. Don't worry about collecting all the tickets, because you won't be able to until the very end. All right, so that's what this is. And we also, of course, have the normal or regular 6th anniversary ticket banner. And this is talking about the 6th anniversary coins, which can be used to exchange for things in the Baba Shop, like Kai's, orbs, trading items, training locations, support items, and also some of the older celebration units, like the Worldwide Celebration Goku, Vegeta, or sorry, Frieza, Badman Vegeta, the STR Yamcha, and of course the anniversary units like the Super Saiyan Blue Goku from last year, Super Saiyan 4 Goku, Super Saiyan 3, and so on and so forth. And this is referring to the red Dragonstone selection. And we'll take a look at the pool in a second as well. This is for the purple Dragonstone selection, which is not free to play. You do have to buy these purple Dragonstones, and they'll be part of some packs for the Dragonstone sale. And in total, you can get up to 3 of them. And as always with anniversaries, these stone sales are generally pretty good. I mean, I believe in total, if you got all the stone sales, you should be able to get around like 1,200 to 1,500 stones. I haven't seen the actual sales yet, so I can't say for sure, but that's just what it's always been, you know? And what else do we have here? Oh, okay, so this is a social media slash SNS event where if you, you know, promote the game, if you share the game, then you get some stones every day. And what else? Okay, Elder Kai banner, new Universe 7 story event, new Master Roshi story event, and by the way, the new Fizz Master Roshi has officially been confirmed to be the next free-to-play LR, and if he's like the Goku Black from last year, then he should be getting an Extreme Z Awakening in Part 3, and I cannot freaking wait for the animation, just for, you know, him to be really, really good, because it's been a long time coming, man. We definitely needed a not overpowered, but just like very powerful Roshi in this game, because he's a character, in my opinion, that has always deserved it, you know? And this one, the Fit Boo event, I believe is kind of similar to the Whis skill orb event, where you can do it once per day, and the skill orbs that it drops, I think, are specifically for representatives of Universe 7 units. So yeah, this one gives out, as far as I'm aware, I could be wrong, but based on what I've seen, it's Universe 7 exclusive skill orbs for this event. And this is the new challenge, like super, super difficult, like extreme super battle road difficulty level event versus the Gods of Destruction. I haven't seen what it looks like yet, but I'm excited for the challenge. And I believe we're getting a brand new stage of Boss Rush. And this should be stage number, I don't think it says, but yeah, there should be a new boss rush, and that's going to be like 35 to 40 stones, once again, pretty easily. I don't think there are any new stages for Extreme Super Battle Road or the regular Super Battle Road, but I believe they'll be available every single day throughout the entire celebration, so if you guys have been slacking or just haven't been able to do some stages, this is your best chance to get all of them done over the course of the month, right? And what else do we have here? So all of the Extreme Z battle events will be available every single day throughout the entire celebration. And we also have the potential orb events available during the weekends for the celebration too. And there's gonna be a special 6th anniversary edition of Ultimate Clash or Battlefield coming as well on February the 1st. And I don't exactly know what this is, but there is the Ichiban Kuji logo here. So I'm assuming that it has something to do with the physical figures that they released for the 6th anniversary. One of them is the, you know, Super Saiyan God Goku. There's also one for the LR Goku Black, the Tech Transforming Trunks. And I also think there's one for the Int LR Gohan and B-Pan. So yeah, it has something to do with that. I don't know exactly what it is, but that's a thing. And we also have every single Dokkan event available every day for the celebration. And these were the countdown stuff. Okay, so yeah, these story events obviously are still available until the end of the anniversary. But of course, they've been here for a while now since the 22nd. We have the shortened stamina refresh, we have the Baba Shop sale, and also 4x rank EXP in the story or quest mode. And that is pretty much it, guys, for part one of the anniversary. It's looking pretty good. Looks like there are going to be quite a few events for people to grind, quite a few things for people to do, which is always a good thing. And before we go, let's actually dive a little bit deeper into some of these other pages here. So for this Ruby Brienne event, like I said, I believe it's one of those community events, and I don't exactly know what the milestones or the missions are, but we all have to work together to accomplish something and, you know, go through the steps, and once we complete each step, we get the rewards, and yeah, it looks like we get quite a few stones, get some Kais, get some, you know, training items, training locations, all that stuff. Hopefully we'll get some nice translations soon, but that is a little preview. And oh yeah, so this is the Ichiban Kuji thing, and like I said, I think all five of these characters or units did get figures for the anniversary, but I don't exactly know what it entails. I mean, it does show some Kais and like a reversal medal, so maybe they're giving out some of that stuff, but I'm not exactly sure. And then we have the special missions, taking a while to load. I think a lot of people are trying to log in right now, so it makes sense. Yeah, so there is this special rainbow ticket, and I don't believe it has any kind of explanation. I think it's just saying like, yeah, we have this special ticket, it's gonna be used later, just collect them for now, and stay tuned for more details. So yeah, we got those special tickets. We have some missions that give us the free-to-play mastered Ultra Instinct Goku, of course some missions for the 66th ticket, which I will provide a different video for you guys in the future explaining, probably tomorrow actually, explaining where to get all the tickets that are available in part one. So keep an eye out for that. And your standard things, right? More copies of the free-to-play Goku, Sleepy Kais, more tickets, and all that good stuff. Oh, Dragon Stones, of course. Those are very important. And what else do we have here? Oh, login bonus. So for the initial login, for the first time you logged in, everybody got 30 Dragon Stones. Oh, my bad. This is not the login bonus. It's the purple stone selection. So once again, you get these purple stones by buying these special stone packs. And just like before, three purple Dragon Stones can net you one of these older LRs, as well as two bonus units. So you can get Mighty Mask, Bojack, Beerus, Super Saiyan 3 Goku, Bardock, Int Gohan, Fizz, Trunks, Majin Vegeta, STR Broly, and Tech Goku Black. And honestly, I mean, I kind of wish they would have introduced some newer units. I know that some of these guys are still quite solid, but I don't see a lot of people getting very excited for these LRs specifically. But nonetheless, still pretty cool. And then for two Dragon Stones, or two purple Dragon Stones, you get a kind of pretty old category lead, as well as one bonus unit. And then for one purple Dragon Stone, you can get a 120 lead, or the Fizz Vegito Blue, who is still easily one of the best TURs in the game with his Extreme Z Awakening, or this AGL Rosé, and that is the purple stone selection. And then for the red stone selection, man, this is taking forever to load. I mean, I've been sitting here for like 30 seconds. Literally since I stopped talking, it's just been non-stop loading. And oh, okay, so we timed out. Is it my connection or is it the game? I think it's the game. I mean, if it doesn't load, then just trust me when I say that. Oh, there we go. Okay, so I was gonna say, your standard red Dragonstone selection. I think it might be the exact same selection as the last time. So yeah, you can get one of these units if you guys are missing them. I mean, a lot of them are really good. So just get one that you don't have and you should be good to go. I mean, some highlights I would say would be Int Janemba for sure. Int Topo, or sorry, STR Topo actually is like an amazing, amazing support unit. Obviously these girls, the Kale and Khalifa, are monsters as well. Yeah, you can't really go wrong as long as you get one that you don't have. Super Saiyan 3 Vegeta, such a beast of a tank, a lifesaver in Super Battle Road and Extreme Super Battle Road. You know, Int Kid Buu, or sorry, Fizz Kid Buu, one of the best supports, if not the best support in the game right now. And yeah, these guys are just all still pretty solid as long as you Extreme Z awaken them, of course. And what else do we have? Oh, here is the 6th anniversary coin thing. It probably just talks about the fact that you can exchange the coins for stuff in the Baba Shop. And this is talking about the new support memory item. If you guys don't know what those are, feel free to go check out my video explaining it. I'll put a link somewhere above my head, okay? And I think that's pretty much it, guys. Oh, okay, two more things. So this one is the login bonus. And like I said, 30 Dragon Stones, one red Dragon Stone for everybody, six of the 66 you know, unit multi tickets, and then we get 5 copies of the MUI Goku. And then for the rest of the days, it's 3 Dragonstones per day, plus anniversary tickets, not the 66 ones, the regular ones, some, you know, coins, some support items, training items, some meats, and all that good stuff. And we also get this special rainbow ticket. We still don't know what it does, I'm pretty sure. Unless they explain it in the news, and I'm just an idiot because I can't read Japanese. I wish I could. I really wish I could, guys, but unfortunately, I cannot. And this last part here is just talking about the different tickets. I think it's going over like what they do, but I don't think there is an explanation for this one. Once again, I'm not really sure, but yeah. Rainbow ticket, we have the 66 unit guaranteed LR ticket, and finally the 6th anniversary ticket. And that is gonna do it, guys, for the first part of the 6th anniversary. I may be doing a couple streams, doing like some of these events. I'll see how things work out, but if I don't, I'll definitely still be bringing you guys some summons, so look forward to that for sure. And guys, I just really hope that all of you guys are happy with part one. Keep in mind, there's most likely still going to be 2 more parts, so the fun is only beginning. And yo, good luck to everybody summoning for these boys right here, okay? I mean, it doesn't really get much more hype than LR Mastered Ultra Instinct Goku and Super Saiyan Blue Evolution Vegeta. So I hope that nobody gets shafted. Fingers crossed. Best of luck to you guys. And yeah, stay tuned for more 6th anniversary coverage coming up over the next couple of weeks. Yeah, I guess there's nothing else for me to say for now. As always, if you guys liked today's video, then make sure to like the damn video. And if it's your first time watching me, first time to the channel, and you like what you see, then definitely hit that big red subscribe button to join the Tiger Squad now. And while you're at it, hit that notification bell too, so that YouTube knows you want to stay up to date with all my latest content. And that's it. I'm out of here. Until next time, hope you guys have a fantastic, fantastic day. I'm Tiger with Tiger Uppercut Media, signing out.